kind of the plan to slow him down a little bit.
I mean, you just said it. We just got to keep filling out the lane. Having 12 and 10 is huge. So, I mean, we just got to do a really good job of keeping him out the lane and containing Odom. They play like all their guards play 40 minutes the majority of the year. So.
Did you watch them play Florida the other night?
No. I didn't watch
them. Jordy, when you look at them, you mentioned they play four guards. I mean, their guards play almost 40 minutes. I mean, they're going to short bench. I mean, how have they been getting it done? I mean, they're almost 500 in the league. I mean,
they're playing 40 minutes, but at the same time, I think Dejon Parker might be 19, Odom 21. So, I mean, they're young guys, so I don't think that's a factor. But, I mean, I don't think teams are getting them into foul trouble. So, if you get somebody in foul trouble who's playing 40 minutes a game, it's going to be tough for them.
Jordan, when defenses sag on the inside guys like they have, especially the other night, do you guys outside take it personally? I mean, is it almost like, you know, are you daring me to shoot? You know, I'll show you what I can do kind of thing? Or?
No, we don't take it personally because, I mean, you have to, even the best defenders in the SEC, you have to double team Jaron and Jarnell just because they're so strong. So they demand a double team. Teams just figure they'd rather us shoot threes than get layups.
Seems like a common approach to these past couple teams has been after halftime they've been able to get to the rim, really kind of bumping up their drives and slashes. What do you guys have to do in order to keep teams from following that approach?
Just after halftime, we got to do a better job of talking on defense because we're down at the other end by ourselves. So we don't have the coaches and everybody on the bench yelling at us. So we just got to do a better job of talking to each other.
What about Antonio, you know, coming back into the starting line? You've been in that situation earlier in your career when you were in and out. You talked to him at all about that?
Yeah, he's fine. Like I said, he's been around long enough playing with Joe down there at Memphis. He's been in and out of that lineup as well. So I mean, he's fine.
How much of a learning experience was that game in Nashville? Just what did you take from that game? What do you think you have to do tomorrow to beat these guys?
We just have to play a solid game tomorrow. You don't have to do anything out of the ordinary to beat them. Just got to play our game, play defense. Key and someone like Rod Odom, who we know that they look for to allow their scoring. He had 26 in Nashville. We need to try to cut that in half.
With Antonio playing more minutes now that he's back in the starter, Coach Martin said that, you know, not so much the scoring, but he likes the way he kind of commands the defense a little bit better. Do you notice that? And what is Antonio being in more, how does that help your defense?
Because Tone can definitely knock down shots. Darius, he doesn't really look to shoot, so teams look to sagging on him. And that's not a bad thing. Darius is just so pass first, trying to get the right people to ball, trying to get everybody involved. So it's just two different games.
Jordan, way before your time, but Dell Ellis, you know, fellow Georgia guy like you, I mean, what do you know about him? He's been around the program since you've been here. I mean, have you seen tapes? I know you've seen the numbers.
Yeah, I've seen tapes, and the fact that a man can score 2,065 points without a three-point line is amazing. So I'm looking forward to seeing him tomorrow and seeing his jersey get retired.
What do you, I guess, not saying on a negative note, but what do you remember about that drive home from Nashville after you guys lost that game? It was a pretty somber trip.
Man, yeah, just any, like any other after a loss. Is, I mean, just because we really wanted to go on a streak and we felt like we had a good chance. But I mean, other than that, I mean, we just got to learn from it.
Thanks, man.
Thank you, Jordan. Thank you, man. Appreciate it.